Hello everyone, this is Link in the channel for Higher Self. Welcome to the Satsang with the Self video series. For these Higher Self videos, I communicate a message from the Higher Self consciousness. This is a consciousness that is greater than our individual self. During the process of spiritual purification, as we remove more of our individual self, we experience more of the greater oneness that we are. Part of this oneness is being connected with and fully part of a universal intelligence. It is from this intelligence that I communicate these messages to you here today. Recently, I have begun a mini-series that I have called Psychology for the Awakened. This mini-series teaches us about the functions of our own human psychology and how we can understand them from a place of higher awareness. For it is when we are able to step out of identification with the processes of our mind, with the opinions of our psyche, then we are able to objectively view and understand how the human ego functions. And in this way, we can more easily purify the layers of our human ego self and step into greater spiritual experience. This is the third video of this Psychology for the Awakened series. In this video, I will talk about the process of thought, where thought occurs within the body and within the human energy system, and how thoughts are formed within you. I hope you enjoy today's Satsang with the Self video. Dear ones, let us begin here and now. For you hear us say this often, for it is the truth of that which you are. In this moment, you will always find yourself. In this moment is where your happiness truly lies. In this moment is the only place you will ever exist. And so, dear ones, begin here and now. As the awareness, as this moment, as all that this moment includes. Understand, dear ones, that all of life is you. All that you see, all that you hear, all that you smell, all that you feel, and all that you taste is occurring within you, within your consciousness. This world and all that you experience of it is occurring within you. You cannot separate yourself from that which exists within your consciousness, and the more fully you are able to accept all of life as being one with you, the more you will find the qualities of divine peace, divine love, divine trust, and divine freedom becoming your experience. And so, dear ones, during today's video, we will examine the process of thought. You, dear ones, live in a world ruled by the mind. You, dear ones, live as a human, conditioned by the mind. You, dear ones, create a life from your mind. The role of the mind is paramount in this human experience, for there is no other part of yourself that has more power over your life and over the direction of your creative energy than the thinking mind. So look, dear ones, at how in each and every moment you typically live within your mind. How you are constantly hearing your thoughts, putting your attention upon your thoughts, acting because of your thoughts, perceiving this world through your thoughts, relating to others because of your thoughts. Look, dear ones, how your thinking mind controls nearly every part of your daily life. Look at how your thinking mind determines how you feel about yourself. Understand how your thinking mind limits your experience based upon the preconceived ideas that it holds within it. In this moment is the experience of freedom. Freedom from all conditioning. Freedom to simply be as you are. Freedom to make conscious choices not influenced by your subconscious mind. In this moment exists the freedom for you to be you, as a conscious creative being in this eternal moment. The key, dear ones, is understanding the mind, understanding that you are not your mind. Understanding that you are not the subject thinking your thoughts, nor the object of your thoughts, but instead the thoughts are simply a process that you are observing. For you are the awareness, you are the creative consciousness, and as this consciousness, you have creative free will over where you place your attention. For where you place your attention determines where your creative energy flows. And the health, the purity of this human energy system determines how much creative power can flow through you in this incarnation. The less subconscious processes you have operating within the layers of your mind, then the more powerful your conscious creative thoughts will be. And so, dear ones, stay in this place of awareness. Stay in this place of freedom. Stay in this place of peace, for it is the awareness that remains for eternity as the forms of experience are constantly undergoing a process of change. You, dear ones, may have a body, a human mind filled with human concepts and human range of emotion. But after this one lifetime, all of these three aspects of your human self will dissolve as you find yourself moving into another range of experience. And as that lifetime comes and goes, you will find those experiences dissolving once again as you pick up a new body and new experiences. And throughout these multiple incarnations in this world and other worlds, you, dear ones, will always remain the same. As the creative consciousness, as the container, as the space, as the awareness in which life occurs, you, dear ones, are the changeless awareness. And you know yourself through your experience of the changing forms. The two, dear one, are interdependent. The two make up your own personal experience within the realm of manifestation.